life? What is life? What is life all about? Is it just living for the moment, the here and now? Or is there more to life? More than just our daily work and routine, punctuated by a favourite sport or pastime. Do we really know how precious life is? How amazing, how fragile, how brief. One day, possibly when we don't expect it, we will take our last breath. Our life will flash before our eyes, and in that moment, what will we see? When we look back on our life, our thoughts, words, and actions, what will we wish we could have changed? Will we simply say, "I wish I had more time to have more fun or more entertainment"? At that moment, the things that so occupied us then will no longer be given a second thought. A man lay dying, and referring to his favourite sport, his friend asked him, "Who do you follow?" When we take our last breath, our sport, our money, music, mobiles are not going to matter to us one little bit. However, the question, "Who do you follow?" is now one that, put in another context, we will wish we had given time and thought to answer. Because the answer to that question will now determine our destiny for all eternity. None of us know what tomorrow or even today will bring. If you died today, are you ready to stand before God your Maker and give account of your life? Every thought, word, action, and motive. God's word says, "It is appointed for men once to die, but after this, the judgment." All of us have sinned, that is, broken God's moral laws and rejected God's gift of salvation. We read, "He who does not believe the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abides on him." If we have not followed God's way to life through the Lord Jesus, who said, "Follow me," then how do we escape the place of eternal darkness and death called hell? And how are we able to go into God's unimaginable heaven? God, in his mercy and love, offers you a gift called salvation, which is eternal life. We read, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." On the cross, the Lord Jesus paid the price and the consequence of our sin, and the gift of God was made available to all who truly believe in him. Maybe today is a time to make a change in your life. One day it will be too late. Live today as though it will be your last. It may be, and one day it will be, and then it is forever too late. Come to God in repentance and faith, and ask the Lord Jesus to forgive your sin and unbelief, and now be your Saviour and Lord. We read, "Whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." To simply do nothing, though, is to reject that gift and opportunity. We read, "How shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation?" This life on earth is but a fleeting few seconds in time. Eternity is forever. Pray for forgiveness and salvation today, for a new beginning, a new life, eternal life.